really did happen to me. A lot of people that look me up on the internet movie database on the new internet will think my first movie was Biloxi Blues. But actually my first movie was The Russellville Story. Any of y'all see it? No. Back in old slavery times in 1972, they started advertising in Russellville, Arkansas newspaper that a movie was coming to be shot there. And if anybody wanted to be in it, you needed to come down, fill out forms, audition, and all like that, at the top of the main of the Russellville building. So, of course, I wanted to do that. I had dancing since kindergarten. I was crazy about being in front of an audience having class. Of course, I wanted to be in a movie, especially if it's going to be shot in my hometown. So we went to Little Rock, came down here to Dealers, bought me an outfit, and we go to this meeting. And I truly don't remember much about the meeting, as frustrated as I was. I just thought, how cool is it that we are in the bank at night? Because I've been to the bank 1,000 times when I ran up and said these little cardboard things and put dimes in them when you got up and put in your savings in.
This is the days before VCRs and things, obviously.
And so, anyway, I was in the meeting on the top floor of the bank at night. You know. Then we go, and there's, oh God, 100 people there, just not even room to sit down. And that's all, whatever. Well, you had to pay $10 a child for your kid to be in the movie. And that's, you know, quite a bit of money in 72, you know. So anyway, of course, why I wrote a check, you know, whatever. So they looked at us. We went to this table and they looked at you kind of by your size and shape and gave you some size. That's what we in the industry call like a little piece of the script, your lines, so that you're auditioning for the parts you get. And they were all little bitty parts, 4 and 5 sentences each, you know. And there was this one and it said sexy girl. And then he handed it to me. Well, now, I was totally round. I was, you know, fat and like I had gotten that way now. And I go, he gives me a sexy girl. And I always danced in front of the mirror. I used to make up things and loved looking at myself, which that's what actors do. And so I beat my part for sexy girl. And the plot of the Russellville story is that these mean kids are coming to town to rob a bank. And so you have the mean kids versus the good kids that are trying to save the town of Russellville and this fight. So anyway, the kids are talking about what they're going to do with all their money once they get back and they beat up. And one says something about, I'm going to buy me a this, and I'm going to buy me a truck, and I'm going to buy me that new wagon. And sexy girl says, I'm going to buy me some new clothes. Come up and see me sometime, big boys. So they just lived a block away from us, which was really cool to have that much family belong into one town. And so I get her full length mirror and I was just looking at me as sexy as a fourth grade girl. And I was just, you know, pressing. I learned the lines pretty quick, of course. And I just thought, come up and see me sexy. And oh, just thought I was so good. Well, so we hadn't had an outfit yet. I got the part. But no. I had to go audition first. I'm joking ahead of myself. When I go to audition, Mother wanted me to wear another cute dress when we'd come to Little Rock and bought it for the others. But I didn't want to. I had a brand spanking new dark purple hang 10 pants outfit. Dark purple, if God could believe, would be his color. Dark purple. And it had a hang 10 little colorful feet right up here at the bosom. And I were in a box, of course, because it was 1972 in Russellville. So I came out of bed, it's like, honey, wear a dress. Little girls wear dresses. Don't wear that big crap. Well, anyway, I'll wear it. And I see kids from my grade school, other grade schools, some girls I've been in grade school, all this stuff. And I started kind of getting nervous. And the other was patting me. He's like, it's all right, come on, you've been on stage, you didn't tell me. We are all right, you'll be okay. I got up, it couldn't be sexy to save my life. I got up there and we were get a lot of this, and then plus kind of the same sometime, then oh wait. Completely straight up. Yeah. Well, unbeknownst to me, my arch enemy from Dover, Arkansas. His name was always in the newspaper. And that's another thing we care about actors. People always ask, oh, do you like seeing yourself up there on stage or up there on the screen? No, we want to haunt. No one likes it. I tell you if you're lying. But I love to see my name. Especially if it's spelled right. Plus, the gloves in my name. Well, Stacy Freeman from Dover, Arkansas, not only was my rival in my Sunday school class at the 5th and Grand Church of Christ, I didn't want to go with my grandparents made me here for this long story. And of the two Church of Christ in Russell at the time, it was the uncool one. So, you know, I had an insult injury. Anyway, Stacy Freeman was always in the paper. Oh my God, you could nothing rest of your career in the paper. Because they were farm ties, and she was showing her hog, or, you know, in my family. And she was in the paper, and I was like, I was having a service dress, I was very proud of her, and it's back in the other. And then for her to get my part as sexy girl in the rest of the story, I didn't understand. Anyway, so I did get a part as just one of the extra bad guys, my first experience being an extra. And we shot it, it was summertime, and all kids were at school, burning hot, just the house of hell open for us to make this look like this. And we're all at like the concrete picnic benches instead of at the park, and we're sitting there, and again, I wore my purple hunting tan to feel a lot of happy. And, you know, she gets up, as a friend who gets up and does it, and I'm just like, oh, my God. Anyway, so months later, months go by, whatever else. There's going to be a premiere of the Russellville story. I start advertising it in the paper. It's on KARB radio. I mean, it's all over. We turn back to the rock and roll dealers, buy me a premiere dress for us. And go, even my days, I'll go, we're all going to go. Load up the car and go see the premiere of the movie. We, at that point in time, there were only two theaters in Russellville, Arkansas. There was the 64 Italian out on Highway 64, which I dearly love, that's where we usually went. Or there was the Ritz Theater, that even my daddy's generation called it the Rats, because it was in such bad shape. So, we always had Saturday night nights, we saw Bed Knobs and Broomsticks, the Scary Car, Choo Choo Bang Bang, you know, some of us saw every kind of movie back tonight. On Saturday night nights, we could sit with the theater and see the Rats. Also, these opening credits lasted longer than the Ten Commandments. It was on and on and on. Every child in Russellville, they got their own screen, and it raised up, and finally my name came up as, you know, the bad guys. And I was one of the bad guys. And I was sitting with them, and I thought my name was spelled right, C-A-N-E-R-D-A-Y. So I was the movie starts. We see the kids out working, what they're doing, and we see the bad kids riding to town, or then we go, and it's coming up on my part, everybody's talking about their money, what they're going to do, and what all this and that. The movie catches on fire. Shortly, as I'm about to roll my eyes at Stacy Freeman from Noah, who stole my part, I'm sexually cruel in the movie, right as I'm about to roll my eyes on the horse of the movie, you see this, whoop, and then he just caught on fire and just burned up. I'm so sorry, there is another copy of the film, but it's in Tennessee. It would take too long to get it here, so be sure to apologize and hope y'all liked what you saw.